Nah.
Perfect. Hey, welcome to another tutorial. So this time I want to show you the eyes of the characters. I want to talk a bit about the creation process I used and what works for me. Most of the times I see junior artists trying to do something very complex, and I will say that in many cases you are not going to need super complex eyes for your character. You will need, of course, complex eyes when you do a Last of Us game. You do super complex characters, you will need complex eyes because this is going to sell a lot of the realism of the character. But most of the times you can get away with more simple eyes that will look very good. For example, you see here in this character, they will work in different distances from the camera. You don't need to get super close to the camera, but they should work as well in close camera. And what I see in junior artists is that they Google realistic eyes, and then there is few tutorials, very nice tutorials, but they will teach you very complex topics, like having the eye in different layers, creating normal and inverting the normal. That's cool, that's interesting, but again, that's more complex. So in this approach, I'm going to show you just a few key concepts of the eye that you will be able to extrapolate and even add more complexity over time. So let's see how we can create this. Okay, first of all, let's go to 3D Studio Max, where I have the character, and let me show you first the structure of the eye, what I have here. So the first thing I have, basically my eye is going to be three things. Mostly, I will go through all the parts, but you can maybe focus on these two. So the first thing is the sphere. The sphere. We want a perfect sphere. We don't want a sphere that, as you see in other tutorials, this part here is somehow inwards or something like this. We don't want to create any artificial thing here on the sphere. Okay, we want something completely round. And it's very important that the sphere is perfectly round, because when the eye closes, the eyelid should flow on top of the sphere perfectly. There shouldn't be any bumps on the eyeball that will create overlappings with the eyelid. The only thing I usually do when I do this sphere, you can use a normal sphere like this with a pole, or you can use a quad sphere with no triangles. It's just a box that you can spherize and then create the round surface, but this is up to you. This works for me, so I will show you how I do it. So basically, one thing that I do extra on this sphere is I will add a couple more of subdivisions here on the frontal part. This is just to have a better reflection. When the specular casts in this area, you will have a better reflection. But that's pretty much it. I don't do anything else on the sphere. I will do a second layer on top that is basically the same geometry. This could be a bit longer. I only did until this point. I will explain you later what is the use of this. For now, I just want to show you the parts, and then I will do this other part, the wet part that connects with the eyelid, the lower eyelid. Okay, let's have a look at the mapping of this. So basically the UV mapping for this is going to be very simple, just a frontal, okay, frontal of a sphere. But the only thing that you will see different, let me show you a checker of this. Let me put a checker here so you can see exactly what I'm doing. Increase the tiling. So yeah, this is it. Okay. Basically, I'm focusing the detail on the frontal part, on the part where is going to be the eye. I don't care about the white part. The white part is wasted space on my UV, so this is it. Basically, all this part is what is going to take the most of the detail. So how to do this? Let me just undo this thing. So what I will do is relax this thing. Okay, so this will be like a flat. This will be the default. It's a flat UV mapping of the frontal of the frontal face. This is the back part. I just detach it and hide it somewhere. So what I do here is I just take this vertex from the center. I grow the selection to this point more or less, and then I will scale it with Control and Alt. I will scale it, and then I shrink the selection. I do the same, scale it up, shrink the selection, scale it up. So what I'm doing here is I'm squeezing the white parts, the parts that I don't really need. I'm just removing space from them and giving it to the part of the eye that I really care. That is the part where the color is going to be. So let's do another one, for example, yeah, this one. So yeah, now basically all this part here taking more space, and this is distortion free and everything here. So the important thing is that now the eye, what I paint in Substance Painter, is should be always in this part. If I don't do this, I'm going to waste a lot of space in white area, and I don't want that, because the white area is going to be white. So I don't really need any detail there. I'm not going to do this, of course it will depend on the type of eye. Maybe you do something more complex with veins and more detail on the eye, maybe you don't want to do this. For me, this is what I'm going to do, is because I'm not doing anything on the white area, I'm just focusing on the color area. Okay, so basically this will be my eye. And the other thing I will UV map is this extra thing, and this is basically a duplicate of the mesh, but the UV mapping is different. It's different because I re-UV map this frontal. I remove all the stretching. I don't do anything with the stretching. And basically, I have the two eyes. Show you the two eyes, because this is something that is important. I have this, it's the same for both eyes. Basically what I do is I do a mirror, so when I paint something I will overlap them, so both of them will be overlapped like this. So when I paint something one side, in the other eye will appear in the other side. That's what I want, but I don't want that for the eye. I want that only for this thing. You will see later when I show you the texture. For the eyes, I want mirroring. But I mean, I don't want a perfect mirror, because if I paint something on the eye, I don't want this to be here and here. I want this to be exactly in, for example, if I paint the specular, I don't want to paint the specular on one side and then appear in the other side. I want in the same direction, right? So you will see that later in the Substance Painter. Okay, so I have this UV mapping, this setup. This thing, I don't really put UV mapping here for this thing. I don't care. It will be just a specular stuff. Okay, so let's have a look at Substance Painter. Substance Painter, let me hide here's this thing. Let's go through the eyes first. I will separate this even though I have it in the main texture with everything. But here in Substance, I separate it. Okay, so here, let me show you a bit of the layers I have. So you can see the detail I have here. It's basically layer. So basically I have, let's do one thing. Let's hide everything. So you see all the layers I have. And this. Okay, so let's start with the standard color, the first color that you want in your eye. As you can see, I use most of the times I use a layer, and then I use a black mask, and then inside that mask I put everything. So in this case I'm putting a shape that is just a normal shape. I can control with this the blurriness of the and of course the scale. I can control the scale also here. Okay. I like also to put blur and on top always, just to blend a bit better the borders. Then I have a second layer. This second layer is a color that goes in the same range, just lighter. In this case, I'm using blue. So this is using another fill layer with another. This is all masks that come in Substance Painter, in the default Substance Painter. I didn't add any extra stuff here. So this is one that is called Circular Spiral Fermat. It's basically this one, I think. Yes, this one. So yeah, as you can see here is dots, but many of the masks here, they have parameters here that you can customize and do something that maybe in the mask, as you see here, the shape that you see there in the thumbnail, when you tweak the parameters, you can change completely the way it looks. So in this case, this thing that is dots, you can transform it into this type of a star. Yeah, and play a bit with it and create whatever. Okay. The pupil is the same. The black mask and the pupil size is using exactly the same the Fermat thing. This one, this alpha. It's just a matter of the density. You will just reduce the density and you will see that it's basically this thing with enough density, you end up with this. I don't want a perfect circle. I just want something like this, and maybe I have a blur here on top to control how sharp I want this. I don't want a perfect. Okay. Another thing, an extra, is the border. It's the circle inverted gradient. It's this one. Basically, this alpha will give you the occlusion that you want in base color. It will give you the volume on the sides. Super nice to add this extra layer of volume. Don't overdo it, just a bit. Another very important is the vertical shade. Basically, this is just a gradient on top and a fill, so I can move it, and it's basically, you can put that in multiply, you can control the contrast, but less. Don't overdo it. Again, it's just a slightly, it's just to create the feeling of occlusion of the eye socket in the eye. Okay, this is a very interesting one. This is, I call it color bump. It's basically the same as the alpha is called shape crescent. You can find it here, this one, shape crescent. So this one is super interesting because it is going to add an extra to the color. Let me show you without it, with it. And the interesting thing here is that you should find a color that should be similar to the color that you are using as a base, but should be a bit different because it will add more interest color. You know, you don't do this, you know, don't do this type of eye. This will look a bit too fake. But for example, if you do let's do, instead of blue, let's go for brown eyes. For example, let's do a dark brown here. In this color, I will do a lighter brown, something like this. And now in the color bump, I'm going to do something a bit more orange, maybe. Maybe something like this. Fighter. Basically this. So with this color, what you want is to just increase a tiny bit the saturation of the color. As you can see, I have here in tint mode more things. So the specular dot, sometimes depending on the type of game, you want to bake this specular, you want to bake the fake reflection on the eye, because sometimes the light of the environment is not going to help to look good. They should have this specular, okay? You should see some specularity on them. If not, they are going to look super flat. And sometimes the environment, then the engine, the environment of your game will not have lights, or will only have one light, or maybe it's just, you know, the position of the character, you know, the directional light is coming from here and the position of the character is in another direction, so you don't really see that specular on your eye. So sometimes you want to fake this, you know. It's not that uncommon thing to do, so you just paint this specular. Okay, you paint this specular white dot. So yeah, I did a correct UV mapping in the end. So this is what I was commenting before about the UV mapping. So if I have here, I have my two eyes overlapped, but if they were mirror, right, what it will happen is that when I move the specular into one side, in the other side it will be in the mirror part of the eye. It will look super bad. And the idea is not that. The idea is that the specular dot moves synchronized with the position of the real position. Okay, so this will be it. When you do this specular, it's interesting that you pay attention to where you put your vertical shade. In this case, I put it from top to bottom, so you won't use this dot on the top. Basically, this is like, as a general rule, you will see that dot where is the darker part of the eye. If you put it, depending on where you put it, you can create interesting effects on the look of the eye, but you want something more neutral for this. Don't overdo it, these dots. If you bake them, don't overdo it. Okay, for me, I'm going to remove it for now. Another thing that is very interesting, so now the specularity, I'm going to use the specularity of the material for this, okay? So the specularity, you won't have this layer here that is just roughness. This is affecting the whole eye. Everything in the eye is going to be this. So roughness, put it like almost zero. So I have this strong dot here. Okay. It's interesting that when you do this in Substance, use an environment that have this type of light, so you can see what you are doing. Something that, you know, you can see reflection. Okay, and now another important one is the normal map. Okay, we are going to use a normal map here, a fill layer with a normal map. This normal, I think I got this from Google. You just Google a sphere normal map and you will see few of them. So basically this is just a sphere, normal map. Flat sphere, you can do this super easy in Photoshop. You put that in the normal map, and then I have here a mask. Let me show you this how it looks. So it's basically this. Okay. So this is the shape. To be more precise with this, avoid mapping. So yeah, it's pretty much just a mask and the other, the this thing, a blur here also helps, you know, to integrate a bit this thing. And the shape here also have hardness. Yeah, pretty much nothing like this. And in the end effect is very cool. I think it adds a lot to the eye. Without, you know, without it, it will look more flat, will look like the sphere it is, but with this you break that sphere, you create this interesting effect that happens in the cornea of the eye. Okay, so basically this is it for the standard eye. And now, a second thing that I do, I think is very important. I don't know if you remember Mass Effect, Andromeda, when they released the game, they forgot one thing. Everyone was talking about the eyes, how lifeless they look, the eyes, and they patched that, and they fixed that. And what they did was simply to add an occlusion. As you can see here in the left, looks very flat, looks everything is lighted, and in the right you see that there is, in the eye socket, there is a feeling like there is something inside, there is occlusion. So that's pretty much what we are going to do here, and that's that second layer that I show you here, this second layer, this is what it is. This is just to have a texture that is going to fake that thing. Why we are not painting this on the eyeball? Because if we paint this on the eyeball, when the eye rotates, that occlusion is going to rotate with the eye, and this is going to look super bad, because when the character moves the eye down, you're going to see a super black shadow coming from the top, and this is not what we want. So let me show you the eye occlusion is this thing here. I'm going to just to hide everything. See exactly. So this is it. Okay. And basically I have here in another texture. Okay. I'm going to put this on base color so you see exactly what is going on. And it's basically this a shape I just configure. And as you can see here, the mirroring is what I need, because when I move these things with the face, when I move this thing, what I need is to adjust to the eye. Okay, so I will move this shape, and I want to make sure that it fits properly as best as possible on the eye socket. So if you will have the same type of mirror like in the eyes, then when you move to the right, it will move to the right, and that's not what I want. I want to have a perfect shape on the eyes. So okay, when I export everything from here, because this thing I will export it as an alpha texture, I will show you in Marmoset how it looks, the configuration of the materials. So basically this is when I export this thing, this is it. I mean, this is how it should look. I have here the eyes. Let me delete the materials I don't use, because I know there is a few that I don't use. It's this one, the eyes. Okay, so I don't use the displacement. I use the normal map, okay? And the normal map is just that round thingy. The roundness map, everything, you know, is coming from Substance Painter. So I don't do any changes on this. The metalness, occlusion, everything is coming from Substance Painter. The occlusion thing. The occlusion thing is basically this. You just put this. There is no need to put an albedo. You just put that texture that you exported from Substance Painter. Should be something like this, you know, like a white thing with a black dot in the middle. And you just put this thing on dither here, and it's basically this. Okay, so when you do this thing, when you activate the alpha, you will see nice occlusion here. So the interesting thing, when this character is rigged, you have to make sure that this extra layer, this occlusion, is skin to the head. So when the eye rotates, and the occlusion stays fixed. Okay, it's very important, because if not, this effect will not have any purpose. But this extra layer is the only purpose of it is to stay fixed, so the eye rotates and this stays in place. Okay, so this is basically it. This is there is nothing more than this. Just make sure that your specular looks good. Just you can even tweak it here. You want you can. Without even using the map, you want to tweak here values instead of using the roughness map just for the eyes. You can activate subsurface scatter. It will help also, you know, it's very subtle, but it will help to scatter better the light, you know, it will give a more gummy looking look into the eyes. And I can show you also, I exported this to Unreal Engine. I can show you how this looks here in Unreal Engine. It's basically the same. The only thing I did was to change a bit in the materials, because I just used the importer from Marmoset. So this material I didn't create it. It was Marmoset. I mean, I created that in Marmoset, but Unreal Engine creates all these nodes. The only nodes I created extra were these to control the metalness, the roughness, and the specular. I use these parameters. I don't use the so I can expose these parameters in the instance here. I have here rough spec and met. They are here, so I can tweak, for example, the specularity of the eye. See, you can tweak it using just this number. So that's pretty much it. That's pretty much it for the eyes. And well, I forgot about the lacrimal stuff. So this, yeah, this thing. This is a very minor detail. I think it helps. It's not really that important to add in your character. I mean, it helps to blend the eyeball with the lower eyelid. It's basically just a cylinder. So you just make sure that it fits well, you know, connects the eyeball with the lower eyelid. And that's pretty much it. You in Marmoset, you have it here. I have this material. Just control the glossiness of it. You know, it looks a bit wet. And that's pretty much it. There is nothing more to do with that. It's super tiny detail. It's not very important, but many of the things that you do here, you know, sometimes things is the sum of everything is what matters. So this is just a tiny detail, another tiny detail, another tiny detail. In the end, all these tiny details will create the nice composition. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to go more in more details. Just, you know, for a standard character, this type of eye should work pretty well. If you want something more complex, of course there is room for improving this thing and adding more complexity, you know, extra details, the vein going, maybe subsurface scatter here in Unreal. You know, you can add complexity on top of this. But most of the times for your characters, this is going to be more than enough. This is already looking good. It's going to look good in a character in a middle distance, you know, so you don't really need to spend too much time in the creation of this. Having later a super complex site, it's very difficult to manage. It's very difficult to rig and skin. So keep it simple. Think on the basics. You know, the way the texture is created, how the colors blend together. This is going to be important to create something interesting. This occlusion thing is very important to create a nice feeling. You know, remember Mass Effect Andromeda, a nice feeling of realism, that the eye socket is properly there. You know, is doing something with the eyeball. And yeah, it's pretty much it. So hope you enjoyed, and let's see your eyes. Okay, bye bye.